Get ready to match the stars from Lou Grant, Robert Walden, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Audrey Lander, Bert Convy, and Patty Dukaston as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rivers.
I got the microphone at last, man.
The old lollipop gambit, huh?
All ready? Yeah.
Like Halloween.
Yes. You ready to have a go at it, Dave?
Yeah, I'm ready to have a go at it. I'll play the
game. Anytime you are.
Let's say hello to our two players.
Why'd you always laugh?
Francis Anderson and Charlie Daniels over here. Current champ is Francis with $600. And she's being challenged by Charlie. The first game they played was a 6-6 tie. And now we're in the middle of the tiebreaker. Charlie's had his question. He's matched five of our stars, and we'll see what Frances does with hers right after we see about this for you. Ready, here we go. That's the other tiebreaker question, Frances. It's all yours. You need five to tie and six to win. Harry said. The ocean is really getting polluted.
Yes.
Yesterday, I jumped in and blanked out. You look at me as if I'm not finished yet. Harry said the ocean is really getting polluted. Yesterday, I jumped in and blanked out. Oh, yes.
Who's taking so long?
Bert.
Yes.
I hear.
What do you hear?
You were consorting with the Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders.
You tell everything, don't you?
Don't tell Audrey.
That it's all going to be on television.
Yes, yes. Oh, it's
when
wonderful.
Will that? What date is that?
January 14th.
That's next week.
That's right.
Oh, yeah.
A 2-hour movie with me and 36 of the prettiest girls you ever saw.
They
in your
really
life.
Are beautiful, aren't they?
Oh, it was wonderful.
Ann go to Dallas with
Ann?
You?
Who's Ann?
Ann, your wife.
Oh, yes. I never take her on the road with me now.
Oh, I see. Okay, here we
37
go.
37 is an unlucky number, right?
Harry said, the ocean is really getting polluted. Yesterday I jumped in and blanked out.
I could say. Got polluted? Drunk?
You what?
Let me see.
You drunked out?
No, couldn't say drunked out.
You polluted out?
No.
What? Is that it? Oh, those are her answers.
Sorry.
All right. Yesterday I jumped in and polluted out.
It was a dumb question.
No, it's a marvelous question.
When
you hear one good answer, you will realize what a good question it was. Show her a good answer, Robert.
It's a garbage question. Garbage out. Garbage.
You haven't heard a good answer yet.
Not a good answer.
Got to match everybody else. What dumb answer did you think of?
I said passed out.
Charlie Daniels, a fisherman from Cape Cod. Get over there in that little blue dot. Francis is leaving here with a pretty good sum of money, $600, and our best wishes to Francis Anderson. Okay. Put her there, pal. Here it is, all for you, Charlie. Big super match. The big money is right here. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Patty Blank. If you match the answer they gave most often, you get $500. For matching the second most popular answer, $250. And then the third,
get
$100.
There's got to be somebody named Patty somewhere.
All right. Whom do you call on?
Patty.
I will call on Charles.
Patty. I'm trying to think of somebody.
Patty. Oh, she
can't
was
think
in
of one?
I can't think of a
Valley of the Dolls. Patty.
That's not how you spell
Duke,
my name.
Duke Astor.
Patty Duke Astor.
I've got a good one.
I have two good.
You want to call?
You're not going to ask me?
Yes, I'm going to ask you.
Deutsch. She always sits in this chair.
Patty Deutsch.
Oh, well, I don't.
Why did you get sick and green when I said that?
And Bert.
Oh, I said, how about Patty Hearst?
Patty Cake.
Okay.
Oh, maybe.
Patty
Cake.
Patty Cake. Now, Patty, at this point, you have the option of choosing one of those, Charlie, or giving us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
I think I'll try Patty Page.
Yeah! Patty Page. Patty Page.
I hope you're right. That's who I thought of.
She really sold a lot of records in her time, didn't she? Let's find out if she's up there. All right. You say you're too old, that all you old fellas remember Patty Page?
Yeah.
All right. Let's see what we've got under the $100 number. Patty Cake. Now, there was a wonderful singer. Patty Cake there. Wonderful. Not a bad actress either. All right, let's see what we got in the $250 number. Patty Dugaston. See?
I'm only 250 because it's misspelled.
That's right.
Yeah.
Right.
That's probably right.
Looks nice, doesn't it?
You're 250,
I think
yes.
I'll drop the Patty and just use Dugaston.
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 Make westerns.
All right, last chance here for Patty Page. Slide the big one.
That's what it is.
Yeah. You got it. Boy, you're on your own. You did very well. That is very good.
Interesting. I would have thought that.
Very good.
She's here all the time.
Well, Charlie, you've won the $500. Means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount or $5,000. But you could be playing for $10,000 if you get a lucky spin of the star wheel. You get one shot at it. It must make one revolution. Good luck to you. Go. There we go. Let's see if you've doubled your money here. If the blue light stays on, you've doubled it. It's all automatic, Charlie. Going to be playing with Audrey. You ready, Audrey? Okay. All right, gentlemen, three back there, facing me, if you would, please.
Yes.
Good luck to you. He'll give a verbal response. You will write yours. Okay. All right, Audrey? This is it. Blank, cold, C-O-L-D. Blank, cold. Blank, cold.
Blank, cold.
C-O-L-D. All right, Audrey's come up with an answer. You come up with the same one, you get $5,000. Isn't this fun?
Oh, yeah, it's really fun, especially if I win.
Yes.
I will say head cold.
Head cold. Now, wait a minute. Head cold is a very common thing in America, and that would be one of the first things you'd think of. Now, if she says head cold, he gets a $5,000. Audrey, what'd you say?
Oh, well... I said head cold.
Head cold! All right, we got $5,600. Better than a day's fishing off Cape Cod, isn't it?
Very much better.
All right. Charlie Daniels is very happy. He's got $5,600, and he says it's better than fishing off a Cape Cod for a day. Make more money this way. We'll introduce another player to you, Charlie. Right now, we want you, America, to watch this, if you please. All right, here we go. Let's say hello. Oh, here's Trina McKay. You remember Trina McKay,
yeah,
don't you? I know a little bit about Trina McKay. She was here before, and I asked a question, and I went over the panel, and they all wrote their answers, and I came here, and I was reading the question to Trina, and I put an answer in the blank. And it was the answer that everybody there had written, and it was the one she was going to say, so it was a little bit unfair to her, so we brought her back to get another shot at it. Now, Trina, tell them where you're from.
Okay, I'm from Dallas, Texas.
Dallas, that's right, Big D.
Yes, the Cowboys.
That's yep. Right.
And I'm a flight attendant for a major airline.
Right.
Enjoy sports and music and dancing.
Okay.
Glad to be here.
All right, Trina, good luck to you. Here we go. You can have A or B.
A, please.
A it is. Now, Art the golfer said, out on the golf course, my drives have been going a little wild lately. In fact, everyone I play with has to wear a blank. Patty, have you finished?
Oh!
Thank you.
Katrina.
Aren't the golfers hit out on the golf course? My drives have been going a little wild lately. In fact, everyone I play with has to wear a blank.
Helmet.
Helmet.
Okay. You said helmet.
Now let's see what we have up here.
I think I caught too many baseball games in high school. I said cup. Thinking of myself,
catcher,
as always.
Yeah. All right.
I don't think I understand that.
You don't understand that? I'll explain it to you later.
I said a catcher's mask.
A catcher's mask. Now, we're looking something like
No need to be hostile.
I'm sorry. Helmet. It's a bulletproof vest.
Bulletproof vest is good. No, all of those answers are very imaginative and quite good, I think. But no match yet for Trina. She wants a helmet.
I said a crash helmet?
That's right. Crash helmet.
Trina from Dallas, did you say from Dallas?
Big D.
Well, I in honor of that, I put a Dallas Cowboys helmet on.
Aha! Look at the star. Yeah. Okay.
Well, first I matched Bobby, but then I chickened out and put helmet.
All right. If you get through in that first round, which is pretty good for first round question, right, Charlie?
Definitely.
You did that in your first game, didn't you? Farmer Brown said.
Favorite farmer.
I don't think my son's going to make a very good farmer. Well, just take a look at him. He's plowing the blank. Okay. Farmer Brown said.
Wait a minute. Gotcha.
I don't think my son is going to make a very good farmer. Well, take a look at him there. He's plowing the blank.
I will say driveway.
Driveway. You say driveway.
Cute. Yeah, that was. Yeah, I'm very close to that, but not exactly right. I don't know what's acceptable: fertilizer or compost. Right?
Okay, he's plowing up the fertilizer.
Flower. Huh? Yeah.
Yes, you're a city kid, right?
Don't they keep it in the driveway?
No. Okay.
I said he was plowing the front yard.
Front yard. Okay, driveway is what we're after.
That's close.
I think my answer is interesting.
We'll be the judge of that.
Plowing the lake.
Very interesting.
Very interesting.
Well, you know, that's possible. If eutrophication had taken place to an advanced degree, you could plow the lake. Hello there.
Hi. I matched Brett, but I said the front lawn.
The front lawn. Listen, you got some fans over there in the corner. You keep giving these rotten answers and they're out there. Yeah, wonderful.
They don't care.
No,
why do they care? Okay. I said the driveway, as a matter of fact.
Driveway! Yay, all right, shows your driveway,
Anna. I believe, as Charles would say, that I have the definitive answer.
City slicker in every bunch. You can't trust those kids from the city there. So we have a score here of 3-1, and we'll continue in a little bit or so right now. Watch this, if you wouldn't, please. Thank you very much.
And our star blanker, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we go to round two. Trina, A or B?
Please.
A it is. Three people play. The entire upper tier. The lower tier lays out.
Hey.
All right.
Did
here
we all get
all
right.
What are we doing?
Are you ready?
Certainly.
Harry said this hamburger must be made out of fresh elephant meat. Oh. I know it's fresh because I took one bite and it blanked.
Hamburger must be made out of fresh elephant meat. I know it's fresh because I took one bite and it blanked.
What do elephants do?
I don't know. It's up to you. You're on your own.
I think that's
would
not
be that.
A wonderful question.
Whatever.
You ready, Trina? Yeah. Come on there, let's go. Here we go. Harry said this hamburger must be made out of fresh elephant meat. I know it's fresh because I took one bite and it blanked.
What's the noise that an elephant makes? Is it trumpeted? Isn't that the word?
Trumpeted is the first thing you said. That's the answer we have to accept.
Yeah, okay.
She said trumpeted.
course she did, because that's right. It is trumpeted.
What do you say?
He wasn't even a member of the Musicians Union, but he trumpeted anyway.
Trumpeted it. Okay.
And it what?
Trumpeted. Trumpeted it. It trumpeted your ace.
No, it sat on a red stool.
Sat on a red stool. You deserve a break today. Ready, Chuck? You know what you have to do?
That's because I got
4 to tie, 5 to win. You got a shot at it here. Here we go. Bert, you lay out.
Yes, sir.
You can always tell.
Oh, no.
I like this one.
Well, can I write?
You can always tell who the good guys are in an old porno movie. They're the ones wearing white blanks. All right, Charles, you can always tell who the good guys are in an old porno movie. They're the ones wearing white blanks.
Shorts?
Let's say goodbye now, Charlie. Fishing is good.
Sayonara,
sayonara, right.
It's not over yet.
No, I don't think he quite understood the picture we were trying to draw.
I know. I was in it. No, yeah. I wasn't. But from my studies and the paper I did in college on socks is what
socks. Remember those dumb old pictures you used to see?
That
all the guys
that
were wearing black socks, and here's... okay. Now, you got to match everybody else to stay in the game and achieve a tie. And here we go with Brett.
Even I, in my naive little world.
Oh, sure.
I live in.
Sure.
And I never saw Deep Throat or What's Your Name or any of that
stuff.
Come
on now, just show the card.
But it's got to be. I feel
lying.
Bad, but it's got. I never did. Yeah. It's got to be stuff.
So that means Tina wins the game and the rest of it. Well, Charlie's leaving here with a pretty good amount. $5,600. It was a pleasure to meet you, Charlie. I'll see you on the beach. Here we go. Tina. All for your benefit. We polled the studio audience and said write down your best answer to this. Sonny Blank. Remember, if you match the answer they gave most often, you get $500. And for matching their second most popular answer, $250. And then $100 for the third. Okay, whom do you call on?
Brett.
Yeah. I can't make up my mind be too... I'm going to say Sonny and Cher.
Sonny and Cher.
Spelling doesn't count. Watch. Trust
spelling
me
really
on this.
Doesn't count here.
Bert.
I would say Sunny Side Up.
Yeah! Sunny Side Up.
Sonny Gale.
Sonny Gale.
Sonny Tufts, at least. Sonny Gale.
Sonny Gale.
Yeah. Okay. Sonny Gale, Sonny and Cher.
Roulette record, Sonny Gale.
Are those?
Sonny Gale, I'll say it proudly. Sonny Gale.
All together.
Socks are you wearing? Charlie's not wearing any socks.
Let me
see, Sonny Gale. You'll say, Sonny you'll laugh
Cher.
On the other side of your sunny
and
side
sunny
of the
side
street.
Up. You want one of those? Or you got a better idea?
No, I think Sunny Side Up.
Sunny Side Up? Okay, that's the answer. Maybe we'll find out if it's up there and if so where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal a $100 response. Sunny California.
Oh, dear.
That's a good one, isn't it? Yeah. All right, let's see what we've got
sunny
under the next
Cher.
One, please. Sunny Side Up, congratulations. You pick up another $250.
Sunny Side of the Street.
Sunny Side of the Street,
yeah,
is that the big
Sunny
one?
Sunny Gale. Sunny Socks.
If Sunny, Sunny Gale Socks. Comes up, you're fired. Okay, slide the big one.
Sunny Gale.
Simple, straightforward,
then
she
direct
changed
answer,
her
to
name.
It. Stop you now and do a little business with America, and then hurry back here. Okay, thank you.
Bert Convy is opening at the Sahara sometime in the near future.
No, I'm opening at Harrah's in Lake Tahoe.
See, you told me Sahara.
Sonny Gale is at the Sahara.
Yes, at Harrah's
in Tahoe.
Harrah's in Tahoe, January 19th for a week with Don Rickles.
Oh, how marvelous.
Should be kind of crazy.
Now, you're in a whole bunch of movies.
We're going to do a series called My Favorite Croatian, right?
My Favorite Croatian, yeah. Now, tell us about the movies you've been doing.
Well, we did one together called Hanging by a Thread.
Right.
I'm doing one called Women in White.
Yes.
Uh-huh. And I might be doing a series. And I'm doing a play at the Solari Theater in Beverly Hills, and I work at Baskin Robbins between Matt and Nathan.
Thanks a lot. Join us next time for Magic Game 79. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.